Now today we have to discuss banking services, and we have already discussed meaning, functions, types of banks that we have already discussed. So what is the meaning of a commercial bank? You can define a commercial bank. Chetan is out. Define commercial bank. Chaitanya, are you there? Okay. Vaishnavi Bhargava, you define what is a bank or what is a commercial bank? What is the meaning of a bank? Definition of a bank. Vaishnavi?
Yes, sir.
Define a bank. What is the meaning of a bank? Sai Ram, please be quick, don't waste time. If you know the answer, then say yes, don't know, then say I don't know, please. Yes, Vaishnavi, can you answer? Vaishnavi, Bhargav. Vaishnavi, sit down. Varsha Vastri. Varsha. Okay, define a bank. Yes, Swastika Nai.
Yes, sir.
What is that? Yes.
Sir, they are the institutions which deal with money. They are of two types, public and private. In public, government banks are there, and in private, private banks. In public banks, they are like SBI and public Axis Bank. So these are the banks for normal people like us.
Okay, good. First, Shivam, what is central bank? What do you mean by a central bank? What do you know about central bank? Central bank. Shivam, are you there?
Sir.
Yes, please.
Sir, the central bank controls.
Sir, it supervise or regulate all the activities of other commercial banks.
Okay. Prakar, you wanted to explain. Yes, Prakar.
Sir, the central bank controls and supervises the other commercial banks.
Okay. Now, how can a commercial bank accept deposits? Methods of accepting deposits. Okay. Urvi.
Yes, sir.
Methods of depositing of money in bank. How can you deposit money in the bank?
Sir, by check.
Which type of accounts can be opened in a bank?
Sir, current account.
Okay. Then okay, Muskan Bhargav.
Yes, sir.
Muskan, are you there? Which type of accounts can be opened in a bank? Types of bank accounts.
Sir.
Okay. Kusagra. No, aapka number ho gaya hai. Kusagra ka number hai. Kusagra. Are you there, Kusagra? सागर गुप्ता, सागर नहीं है, खुशी गुप्ता। टाइप्स ऑफ बैंक अकाउंट्स,
सर
हाँ जी,
सर फिक्स्ड अकाउंट एंड करंट अकाउंट।
ओके हाँ जी बोलिए। लक्ष्य दिव्या का आपका नंबर, दिव्या दिव्या कैन यू आंसर?
सर मैंने बोला
अकाउंट, सेविंग अकाउंट।
हाँ दक्ष बोलो।
सर फिक्स डिपॉजिट, रिकरिंग डिपॉजिट, करंट अकाउंट, सेविंग
अकाउंट। भूमि जैन
सर व्हाट
दिस टाइप्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स?
फिक्स्ड अकाउंट, सेविंग अकाउंट एंड करंट अकाउंट।
आदिति आदिति सोनी
यस
सर, टाइप ऑफ अकाउंट्स?
Types of accounts. Current account, savings account, fixed deposit account or FD, recurring deposit account or RD.
Okay. So now we have discussed these types of accounts, methods of granting loans by commercial banks. We have also discussed other functions performed by a commercial bank. We have also discussed electronic banking or e-banking and the benefits of e-banking to customers as well as to the banks. No, that we have already discussed. So now we are going to discuss recent electronic services provided by commercial banks. No, what electronic banking services are provided by or e-banking services? How has it brought a change in the life of a common man? That we have to discuss today. So some recent methods, especially methods of transfer of funds. Let us see first. This is it visible? Screen is visible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let's see this first, then we will go ahead.
A commercial bank is a business enterprise in the financial sector. Unlike other banks, such as cooperative banks and development banks, for example, the chief motive of a commercial bank is to make a profit. There are scores of individuals with money, and there are scores of individuals and business prices who need money for various purposes. A commercial bank makes a profit by connecting the two and leveraging the funds that flow between them. Here's how. The bank accepts deposits from the public at relatively low interest rates and provides loans to its customers at relatively high interest rates. The difference between the two is the bank's profit. Acceptance of deposits is one of the primary functions of a commercial bank. What differentiates these deposits from deposits at other financial institutions is that these deposits are repayable on demand and are withdrawable by check.
draft, ATM, and other means. As a customer of a commercial bank, you could choose to deposit your money in any of three types of account. Savings account. If you want to be able to withdraw your money anytime, but not very frequently. Current account. If you are a business person who needs frequent deposits and withdrawals. Fixed or time deposit. If you can afford to keep your money low, press the rate. The rate of interest is different for each type of account. The money received as deposits by the bank is in turn provided to other individuals and enterprises as loans. Lending or advancement of loans is another essential function of commercial banks and its chief source of revenue. If you wanted a loan from the bank, you could opt for any of the following options. Term loan, where interest is charged on the entire loan amount for a fixed period. Cash credit, interest only charged on the amount drawn and not on the entire loan amount. Discount bills exchange, where the money you owe to a creditor is simply paid by the bank for a small commission. Overdraft facility, where, as a business person, you can withdraw more money than you have deposited in your current account and pay interest on that amount. This system of loans and deposits enables a third function of commercial banks, which is the transfer of funds through instruments like checks, demand drafts, and net banking by phone and computer. Banks provide one of the most reliable and convenient modes of transfer of money in present times. As core of the modern financial system, commercial banks are well positioned to provide agent services to their customers. On behalf of its customers, the bank can make and collect various types of payments, such as insurance premiums, loan installments, electricity bills, sale and purchase of securities, dividends and pension. For companies, banks act as underwriters for new issues of securities, in addition to providing regular banking facilities. Merchants also provide customers with services buying and selling foreign currency, maintaining and executing wills of customers, and providing lockers for safekeeping of valuables.
Okay, this much we have discussed. All these functions, types of banks, methods of granting loans, methods of accepting deposits by commercial banks, this we have discussed. Okay, so now let us see some more things. For that, let me use whiteboard. Is it visible to all of you? Sairam?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now I want text on it. Here is the text. Now we are discussing here e-banking. Or electronic banking. Okay. We have already what are the merits and demerits of meaning and merits and demerits of this e-banking or electronic banking. So what are the instruments used as a part of e-banking? We can say ATM. Debit card, है ना? First instrument that we have discussed. I have discussed it with you many times. Sairam, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
So this is the first instrument that we are using because of electronic banking. ATM card, that is automatic teller machine. This card can be used for what? This card can be used for withdrawals, means withdrawing the money. We can transfer also, transfer of money. Okay. And it can also be used for making payments. Okay. So by using this ATM card or debit card, we can do these things. We can withdraw money, that is normal feature, that we withdraw money from ATM terminal. We can also transfer money by using our ATM card, no? And we can make payments. No, many of you must have used this ATM card for making payments. So when we go for shopping, then SOP, and a point of sales machine is there. And at that point of sales, you go for a grocery shop or you go for the shopping malls where you can make payments by using your ATM cards. Okay, Sairam, are you understanding?
Yes, sir.
Sairam.
Yes, sir.
This is the first most important instrument under the electronic banking system. So this all you understand, that if you have a savings account or current account, what you need, either you should have a savings account or current account. In this case, you can get ATM card, you know, on FD and RD. ATM card is not useful because the money is not withdrawable in a before a fixed period of time. So that's why this ATM card is issued to the customer. So basically, your account is connected with, account is connected through internet banking, you know. Internet banking. So whatever transactions you conduct by using ATM card, they all are recorded to your account. Nowadays, ATM machines are also used for depositing the cash. So you know the process. You have to go to the ATM booth, insert the card. It will go for authentication. Will ask for the service which you want to use, banking or withdrawals or whatever. Then it will ask for your password. So you have to give the password. After that, it will ask what message you want to withdraw of money. Then it will ask how much money you want to withdraw. That all information from which account, savings account or current account. Then it will give you the necessary amount of money. So I think that many of you must have used or must have seen that how to use ATM card. So this is the assignment for you, that you go to ATM booth along with your parents whenever you find time. And if it is allowed, abhi mat jana, abhi pulang sir ne bol diya corona chal raha bahar bhej diya. So don't go abhi right now, mat jana, jab ye situation normal ho jayegi. And if parents permit, go with the parents and accept password. Don't see the password, what parents are putting the password. Accept password, you see the whole process, how is the money withdrawn from the ATM booth. Is it clear, Sairam? Sairam.
Yes, Sairam. Sir.
Am I correct? हाँ, तो ये practical application समझना है आपको, है ना? If possible, you can वहाँ पता नहीं मत करना, वो allowed नहीं है, ठीक है छोड़ो उसको, ऐसे ही बस जाके देखना समझना, and write it on a piece of paper about did you understand at that place. आपने क्या सीखा, कैसे समझे, कैसे यूज करते हैं, वो लिखना है आपको. फोटो खींचना अलाउड नहीं है, आपको खींचना फोटो नहीं बनाना होता है, इट्स अ प्रोहिबिटेड प्लेस, डोंट मेक अ वीडियो, बट यू कैन राइट ऑन अ पीस ऑफ पेपर दैट व्हाट डिड यू अंडरस्टैंड. सायराम, हैव यू अंडरस्टूड इट? सो दिस इज वन प्रैक्टिकल थिंग दैट वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड, हाउ टू यूज अवर एटीएम कार्ड्स. ओके, हाउ टू विथड्रॉ मनी फ्रॉम एटीएम बूथ. And if you are able, you can understand more features or more functions of ATM card. उससे और क्या कर सकते हैं? That you try to understand practically. Okay, Sairam.
Yes,
sir.
Second instrument, we are using credit cards. No. Credit cards are also used for making payments, no? For making payments. This also we have discussed, no? So, a credit card is issued by a bank, and a bank fixes the credit limit of every customer. Up to your credit limit, you can make payment for shopping by using the credit cards. If you have taken credit card from any bank, then that credit card will be used for making payments. Whether you have balance in your account or not, make the payment by using the credit card. This is basically a loan given by a bank to you, and bank will charge the interest on the amount paid by credit card if this is not returned to bank after a specific date. Now, so there is a date. By that date, you have to return this money to bank. If you don't return that money up to that date, bank will charge it interest from you. So that credit cards can be used for making payments. Okay. What these two are called? These two are called plastic money. Common name used for this is the plastic money. That means plastic money is referred for debit cards and credit cards. Hey Ram. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So this is good mode where you can go for shopping, or you can conduct many financial transactions without using the cash. Na? But some precautions are to be taken. There is a huge possibility of fraud or cheating in case of internet banking or online transactions. So be very safe. Conduct it safely. It is advised that don't use others mobile phones or others laptops when you are making these activities, or keep your password safe. Make a strong password that cannot be broken. Now, don't disclose your password to anyone. Keep your card safe. So that some precautions are to be taken, so you will be safe. Okay. If someone asks to you, by some fake calls are received. Sometimes someone is asking for your password, or someone is saying that you, this is the value sensor for you, so give me your password or number. So don't disclose the details of your card to anyone else. Okay. Sairam. Okay. So sometimes this type of practices are used by people to cheat you. Now, after this, the most important internet banking instrument is nowadays net banking. Net banking or internet banking. This is the most wide facility which is provided by the commercial banks, that is for net banking or internet banking. So you have to go apply to the bank, or you can get it through YONO app also, that is online banking. In this case, online banking services are provided by bank to you. You have to create your password, and you can log in the net banking or online banking by using your password and login ID. You know, so you have to create a login ID, password, and by using that login ID and password, you can use bank net banking services facilities. This net banking is a 24/7 services available. Just like ATM facilities are available, so you can use this net banking services for checking the balances of your accounts. Nah, you can see your accounts in front of you. As soon as you will go for net banking, you will log in, put your password, your account will open in front of you, whole screen will open. So what you can do by using net banking? Number one, by using net banking, you can check balance of your account, you can check the transactions which are conducted. You can see the whole statement of 1 year, 2 year, that all transactions you can check, that all are open in front of you if you are using the net banking. Are you understanding, Sairam? Sairam?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So you can check the balances. You can check how many deposits I have in my account. whatever deposits you have made in that bank. You know, suppose you have account in State Bank of India and you have made some FDs, fixed deposits, recurring deposits, you have a savings account, you have the current account. All these will be viewed or can be seen by using net banking. So you can check all, and you can even check that which are the transactions I conducted in a specific account. You know, what are my transactions in savings account in last 1 month or last 10 days or last 2 months, that all you can check. So you can get detailed information about your bank accounts, your deposits. You know, and you can also see that who has deposited money in your account or at what time, how much money is withdrawn by you. That all can be seen. Second is net banking facilities used for making payments. You know, you can make payment to anyone by using net banking facility. For that, you need account number of the person to whom you want to transfer money and IFSC code of the bank that customer you are transferring the money. IFSC code means a month. Can you give full form of IFSC? Yes. Sairam. Sairam, yes, am I audible sir. Or not?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Do you know this IFSC? This Indian Financial Services code. Okay, this is the identity of bank and its branch. You know, this is different for each branch of the bank. For example, you can see I'm writing here for this Gale branch SBI. You know, so this IFSC code is SBIN0006635. This is the IFSC code of this branch, Gale branch. You know, so how many digits are here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So whatever bank you are using, any bank if you are using, this IFSC code will always be of 11 digits. You know? In IFSC code of any bank, there will be 11 digits. This is the identity of the bank. So this 6635 is the branch number of this bank. You know? SBI Gale branch, its code number is 6635. So that is the identity of the bank branch. So that we need two things. Number one is account number. If you want to transfer money to someone, you need the account number of that person. Okay. Account number and IFSC code. If you want to transfer money by using net banking facility, so you can transfer any amount to anyone. Are you understanding what I'm trying? So now this transfer came maybe of two types, same bank, other banks. And one more transfer is directive transfer. Three types of options are there. Same bank means SBI to SBI. Your account is in the State Bank and you want to transfer to the customer of SBI, same bank. No. Other banks means your account is in the State Bank, but you want to transfer the money to the account of a customer who has the account in Punjab National Bank. In that case, that is the other bank. And quick transfer. So what happens in here, in case of other bank transfer, we have to first add the beneficiary. You know, add the customer to whom we want to transfer money. It takes some time. So if you want to transfer more than 20,000, then it cannot be transferred without adding the beneficiary. पहले उसको add करना पड़ेगा अपने account में और जब वो add हो जाएगा तब आप उसको transfer कर सकते हैं. But quick transfer is a different facility. Up to 20,000 rupees can be transferred quickly to any of these two. Either you want to transfer in the same bank or other bank without adding the beneficiary, you can transfer the money quickly without adding the beneficiary. So that time of adding the beneficiary is saved. Up to 20,000 rupees can be transferred without adding the beneficiary. And this net banking basically use NEFT. Now we will discuss about this. We will discuss in detail about this NEFT. This is full form is National. Who will tell it? Any one of you know full form of NEFT? Have you heard this word NEFT?
Yes, sir.
Sairam, what is the full form of NEFT? हाँ बताइए. गूगल बाबा यूज किया क्या? किया सही राम. फुल फॉर्म ऑफ एनईएफटी, इट्स नेशनल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक फंड ट्रांसफर. नेशनल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक फंड ट्रांसफर एनईएफटी. And second one is also here, that is called RTGS. RTGS. These two are the systems of transfer of funds from any part of the country. Okay, both are same. Both are nation-wide system. All India transfers can be made by RTGS or NEFT using any of these two. Only the difference is of the amount. A small amount, if you want to transfer, then you use NEFT facility. And but if you want to transfer big amounts more than 2 lakh rupees, then use RTGS. Its full form is real time gross settlement. RTGS means real time gross settlement. Real time gross settlement. क्या हो गया इसमें? इसको गड़बड़ हो गई. Gross settlement. Here are the two services which are used for funds from one place to other place, RTGS and NEFT. You can do NEFT from your own e-banking facility. अगर आपके पास e-banking है तो आप खुद ही NEFT करके भेज सकते हो, वैसा RTGS कर सकते हो. And if you don't have this net banking facility, you go to the bank, fill a form, give all the details, and this all will be required. SBI and that IFSC code will be needed. This account number will be needed, amount will, that all you have to fill in the form. Then bank will make NEFT or RTGS on your behalf. So if you have net banking service, you can do this by your own. If you don't have net banking service, then you can do it through bank. These two we will discuss in the next class. Right now I am stopping and coming back to the meeting. Okay, Sairam. Now, if you want to ask anything, you can ask. If you have any doubts, this is the last topic in banking. That is the banking services, electronic banking services. After this, we will go for the next service. That is the insurance in the next class. Okay. So now, if you don't have to ask anything, you can leave. We're stopping recording.